live there. But many of you have seen the email. We've been announcing this for a couple of weeks. We have the incredible blessing of having Dan Moeller, Danny Moeller, with us. I don't even know what she prefers, but I've been knowing Danny, I think, for well over 20 years. And certainly he's an incredible man of God to still be willing to be in fellowship with me after so long. That's a tribute to his character. But over the years, I've come to just incredibly appreciate who he is, the deposit that the Lord has made in him, and the work to which he has called him. He was an incredibly faithful son to his parents, and more than that, he is an incredibly faithful son to his heavenly Father. And he is walking out the calling and the vision that the Lord has given him for El Rancho Del Rey. And we are excited, Danny, to have you with us. And we are so excited to hear the good things that the Lord has put on your heart for us. And I hope you've got some air in your lungs, because we're really going to want to hear what you have to say. So Danny, would you come forward, please, and share with us what you have on your heart for us. But let's warmly welcome Danny Moeller.
Buenos dias. A lot has happened in the last 20 years since I was here with you. I used to come to this congregation holding the hand of my parents. They'd call me up sometime in their time of sharing, and I would come up and sing a song and play my maracas, and then go back to the pew and fall asleep. And now I'm in their shoes. I'm before you as the second generation of Moellers, bringing you a report, bringing you good tidings of what God is doing in Rancho del Rey, in the ranch of the King. And it is a privilege to be here today, to see this congregation, to see the faces that I've seen before since my childhood, some new ones, to even hear the bustle outside. Feels like home, just feels like home. So thank you so much for having us. Thank you, Pastor, for your warm welcome. Thank you for being here today, for being faithful, for being a faithful congregation, for loving the Lord, for worshiping the Lord in spirit and in truth. Thank you, ministers of music and song and instruments and dance, for your ministry among us this morning, because you prepare the way for what God wants to speak to our hearts. Thank you to all who have visited us in the past also, prayed for us, believed in the ministry of Rancho Del Rey. Thank you for being our friend. I'd like to share with you a scripture this morning, but before that, I'd like to just have a word of prayer, if you would allow me. Padre, en el nombre de Jesús, te doy gracias en esta hermosa mañana, porque tú estás aquí, porque tú llegaste aquí antes de que nosotros llegáramos, porque tú llenaste este lugar con tu espíritu, cada banca, cada pasillo está impregnado de la presencia del Altísimo, y lo sentimos y mi alma lo sabe bien. Y Señor, en esta mañana yo bendigo a tu pueblo, yo hablo sobre ellos una bendición que sea derramada sobre sus vidas, sobre sus familias, sobre su salud, sobre sus finanzas, sobre la alegría de su alma. Restaura en cada corazón, Señor, el poder y la alegría y el gozo de tu salvación. Restaura aquello que el enemigo piensa que les ha robado. Restaura, Señor, y haz algo nuevo en medio nuestro. El día de hoy, pero a partir de hoy, haz algo nuevo. Confiamos en ti. We trust you, Lord, to do a new thing in our midst. We trust you, even as you arrived here before we did. You filled every bench. You were in every hallway. Your spirit moved upon us before we even arrived. And we thank you for your presence, Lord. We acknowledge the presence of Jesus in our midst today. And we glorify your name, Father. Speak to our hearts today, Lord. Let us hear your voice. In the name of Jesus, amen. I asked my brother to put up a scripture. Is it there? Oh, I'm there. My bald spot's there. Okay, well, that's a start. Okay, there it is. I'd like to share this scripture with you in the book of Esther. And I'm just going to paraphrase. And Esther got all dressed up. And she stood in the courtyard waiting. And the king was seated on his throne. But he lifted his eyes and he saw Esther. And he extended his scepter unto her. And she drew nigh and touched the tip of the scepter. And he said unto her, My queen, what would you have me give you? What would you have me do? This morning, as I walked into this temple, into this place of worship, I was just flooded with memories of my childhood, of people hugging me and greeting me and telling me how welcomed I was. But you know, it happened since Tuesday when I arrived at the airport and Pastor David hugged me at the airport. He extended a scepter of mercy unto me. And then each one of you in the following days, as I've slept in four different beds since I got here, but every one of those beds and every one of those homes was an extension of God's scepter to me. And I was reminded of our children at Rancho Del Rey. When they come to Rancho Del Rey, Rancho Del Rey is an extension of the scepter of mercy and grace of the Lord, of a new opportunity and a new hope that is given to each one of these children. And we will not stop until every voice of each one of these children is heard. Until each one of these children in the courtyard is seen, even as Esther, an orphan herself, was heard and seen. She knew that she was called for a time such as this. Rancho Del Rey is called for a time such as this to share the good news that there is hope and there is a future, that God has promised these children a hope and a future. And it begins for many at Rancho Del Rey. And you are an extension of that, of that scepter of grace and mercy and opportunity. And I'm here to tell you that for 66 years, Rancho Del Rey has been able to extend that scepter to over 2,000 children and counting. And in the last few months, the Lord has brought to our attention that there's Esther's still waiting in the courtyard. There are girls, the sisters of our boys, knocking at our door, saying to Susan Mino, who many of you know, get me out of here. Get me out of my colonia, out of my barrio. Take me anywhere, I'll go anywhere. And her heart has been broken once and once and over again. As she has to say, I see you, I hear you, but I can't tell you at this moment, what would you want of me? Even up to the half of my kingdom I will give you. She can't say that yet, but we're praying that we can say that. We're praying that we can extend the program of Rancho Del Rey to the Esters waiting in the courtyard. A lot of these girls are pleading with us, are asking, many are silent, but you can see in their faces that they are desperate to get out of there. And if we don't help these girls, these Esters, they will be overrun by those that are the enemies of the kingdom, the enemies of God's people, and maybe even pregnant by the age of 14. So we need you to join us in prayer, in hoping, in believing that God can extend his scepter, that his arm is not short to save, that he is able and willing to do far beyond what we can ask or think of in favor of these Esthers. But in the meantime, we have a job to do. We have a work to do among the boys, and we can't leave that on the side. We can't forget that. We have projects at hand that need to be finished, that you have helped to begin. There's a lot of work to do, and I know that I'm preaching to the choir here, right? You know what need is. You know, they're right out there, you know? The world needs us. But in our corner of the world, this is our reality. The courtyard is full of children that need to be seen, that need to be heard, that need to be acknowledged, and that need to be given hope and an opportunity. So today I would like to present to you a video, a beautiful short video that has been prepared to help you see some of the work of Rancho Del Rey. Many of you have maybe have already received this in your emails, and if you have, please bear with us. If not, enjoy the video, and then Susan will be sharing a few minutes from her heart and her vision. Who is Susan Mino? Well, Susan Mino was a church member who had heard of Rancho Del Rey for many years, had heard mom and dad speak at her church in Massachusetts, and praise the Lord, she never had to hear me sing and play my maracas, but she had heard of the ranch. And then in the later years, in 2009, she was able to get on a plane and come and visit Rancho Del Rey, and she was hooked. She came into that courtyard and she saw for herself the need, the hope in the eyes of the boys. And she said, I want to be a part of this. And since 2009, she and her husband, Michael Mino, have had just a tremendous influence on the boys, on their daily walk with Jesus, but also in just the practical things of life. Michael has set up a beautiful worker space for them, a maker space, which she will probably be telling you about, but she has been such a blessing. And they have come alongside me and my team for the last 10 years, 12 years, for a time such as this. Right when my parents were about to receive their promotion, here comes Susan and Michael, and what a blessing they have been. They also are an extension of God's scepter of grace and mercy and opportunity. Enjoy the video, and we'll be here to talk with you and to share with you, but as far as it comes to me, gracias por ser parte de este ministerio, por creer que hay esperanza para estos niños. Gracias por creer que no estamos limitados solamente a nuestro espacio, sino podemos ir a todo el mundo y predicar el Evangelio a toda criatura, porque este es el llamado verdadero del pueblo de Dios. Y les agradezco por hacernos partícipes de este pueblo, de este cuerpo de Cristo en Filadelfia por tantos y tantos años. Gracias por ser nuestros amigos. Thank you for being our friend and for believing in the ministry of El Rancho Del Rey. God bless you, and I think the video is ready. We love you.
You are not hidden. There's never been a moment you were forgotten. You are not hopeless. You have been broken, your innocence stolen. I hear you whisper underneath your breath. I hear your SOS, your SOS. I will send out an army. Find you. true, I will rescue you. There is no distance.
Come and go with me to my father's house. desde pequeño. Buenas tardes. Le voy a contar mi testimonio de cómo yo siendo un niño en la calle, yo vivía con mis abuelos. Mi madre me dejó a los...
Raúl, y tengo 12 años y me gusta estar aquí en el Rancho del Rey porque nos apoyan también a mi familia y tengo amigos con quien jugar, nos dan escuelas y nos tratan muy bien. También aquí nos hablan de la palabra de Dios y hacemos proyectos en el laboratorio y regalamos juguetes para los que nos lo necesitan y gracias por apoyarnos.
Thank you back there for helping me with that. Praise the Lord. The blessing that Rancho Del Rey has been in the lives of many generations of children is evident. Just a month and a half, I think, before I came on this trip, I got a knock on my door. I opened the door and there was a 70 plus year old man saying, "Hi, I'm your big brother." And I said, "No, you ain't. I don't know who you are." He says, "I'm Refugio." Refugio, which means refuge. He says, "I'm your big brother because I was at the ranch before you were born. And my two brothers and I were there when you were born, and I used to babysit you. And I'm coming today to invite you to my 50th wedding anniversary. And since mom and dad," he calls my mom and dad his mom and dad, "since mom and dad are no longer here, would you please come in their behalf?" Of course I went, and I was overwhelmed to see the ripple effect that Rancho Del Rey has had in lives. Just in one life, now in many, but that day it was one life. But the ripple effect was in like 60 or 70 people in that room. They were all kissing him and hugging him. And I thought to myself, here's a boy, here's a man who has all the reasons in the world to be bitter, to be mad with the world and with life. And yet he is a loved man. Truly, the Lord has turned his circumstance around. And Rancho Del Rey was key in that, in changing his reality. A child who had been orphaned from his mother at the age of 2, I believe that's what he said, and thrown across the room by his father or stepfather, and then just got rid of by his stepfather, brought to Rancho Del Rey. But what was a curse in that moment turned into the greatest blessing of his life. And he was a loved man. He was a man that was celebrating his 50th wedding anniversary. The cycle had been broken. The curse had been broken. He had not only been heard, he had been seen. And he had been given an opportunity and a hope. And Susan Mino is going to share shortly these opportunities and these hopes with you, which you have made possible. Susan?
Calls me Dingbat. Anyway, I'm so grateful. Okay, I'm short too. I'm so grateful. Les damos saludos de la parte de los chavos. We say hello and send you greetings from all the staff. All of them say hi. From the new boys that I haven't met yet, Johan, Marco, Santiago, at least there's three names I remember. Little boys, Diego, Damian, Jesus, Axelito, Luis, big boys. They've gotten so big. We had a bunch graduate this year, some new kids with all the same needs. And those are the kids that you know here in Philadelphia. I was reading this morning in James and thinking about the kids and their moms, and I read this, which you all know well. Pure and undefiled religion in the sight of our God and Father is this: to visit orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself unstained by the world. Those things all in the same sentence. It is a big sentence, rich with meaning. But it's the orphans and the widows. And I see those kids' moms like widows. They have been abandoned over and over and over again. And our heart has been just so broken for the kids, for their families, for their sisters, for the community. And I just have to say that being away from Rancho Del Rey for the past few weeks, the Lord has really talked to me about, what do we want? What is our goal? We talk about healing hurts through hope. Those boys in that, they believe it. It really struck me watching it this time, based on some things they said to me, a few of them said at the very end, the ones that graduated, and some drawings they made. They really believe that their hurts are being healed by hope. They really believe there's a hope for their future. And one little, no, he's not little anymore, he's 16. We were singing, or somebody was saying the well-known verse, "I know the plans I have for you, plans for a hope and a future." And Jair just looked at me and went like this. Like he knew it was true. And if there's anything that they get out of Rancho Del Rey is hope that they do have a future. But what is it we really want from them? So this is the hymn the Lord gave to me this morning. Sorry, I'm very emotional. I don't know. I'll tell you why in a minute. Jesus, I am resting in the joy of what thou art. This is what we want for our kids. And this is what we want for their moms and their sisters. I am finding out the greatness of thy loving heart. Thou hast bid me gaze upon thee, and thy beauty fills my soul. For by thy transforming power, thou hast made me whole. Oh, how great thy loving kindness, vaster, broader than the sea. Oh, how marvelous thy goodness, lavished all on me. Yes, I rest in thee, beloved. Know what wealth of grace is thine. Know thy certainty of promise and have made it mine. This is the desire of our hearts for us, for those children, for their moms. And we have been doing, I think, probably 10 months of real serious soul searching, how to bring that to pass, how to be the best stewards possible of your investment. You know, the difference between, you know, giving somebody a sandwich and buying them a cow so they can, you know, or buying them a glass of milk and then, or buying them a cow. How can we best serve these children, families, and lead them to this point where they learn the joy of who Jesus is? And the contrast between that hymn and the filth and the stink of the places we routinely visit is just so stark. Yet, and sometimes I'm tempted not to have hope, and I'm sure you all living where you live, it's tempting not to have hope for whatever reason. And I sat here thinking, this gives me hope. You all give me hope. Being here makes me feel that as crazy as we sound, we want to do programs to the moms. We want them to be able to come stay on the campus. We want to be able to give them some refuge on weekends from their abusive situations. We want to teach the moms how to eat right. We want them to know what it feels like to be taken care of well. We want to be able to teach them to read, to have a dignified job, to be able to take care of their kids. They don't know how to play with their kids. They come to visit their kids and they hand them a cell phone. They have no idea how to relate to their children because their mothers didn't relate to them. So our heart is, and as we have conversations with Beth and I've had conversations with Liz, what can we do, Lord Jesus, for these families? So some of that unfinished construction relates to that desire, but also to serve the kids, to take advantage of the talented staff we have. We have prayed for talented staff. I have given my list of to the Lord. Okay, I want this one to have experience in this. I want this one to love Jesus. I want this one to be able to relate to the moms. I want this one to have her own car, to be prompt, to keep appointments. And the Lord Jesus has been answering those crazy detailed requests for staff plus. We've gotten singers and musicians and one man experienced with music therapy and artists. So we're just praying that the Lord will bring us more into the realm of art and music therapy to work with kids. We also have found that working with wood is very therapeutic for them. The littlest boys have access to all the machines. They've learned how to use them safely. They've learned how to make toys and gifts for other poor people. They don't think of themselves as poor anymore. That facility also will serve our staff and help build up our staff as well, because our staff are our best treasures, and they are treasures. And we need to take care of them, because it is a high burnout job for any of you who work in childcare or in public services especially. No, it can be exhausting. So we want to do better with our staff, do better with our boys, look harder, continue to look hard at long-term success with them, to love their moms into health, and to love their sisters. So that's the vision the Lord has given us. Jesus, I am resting in the joy of what thou art. Meanwhile, mientras, estamos esperando los tiempos de Dios. We are finding out the greatness of his loving heart in his way, in his time. And we are claiming, hi Aaron, I just saw you. We are claiming promises and resources from the guy who owns the cattle on a thousand hills. I still sing that song from my childhood. He owns the cattle on a thousand hills, the wealth in every mine. He owns the rivers and the rocks and rills, the sun and stars that shine. Wonderful riches more than tongue can tell. He is my father, so they're not mine as well. He owns the cattle on a thousand hills. I know. What do we know? We know that they're ours as well. And his blessings are ours as well. His promises are ours. They are for this church. I know this church has gone through hard times, because we've all gone through hard times. And I can see by looking at you, the church has gone through hard times. But the promises are for you. And the blessings that are following and will follow your faithfulness towards Rancho Del Rey will continue to be multiplied throughout generations and generations and generations, as long as the Lord tarries. And then even then, when we're all together in heaven, you'll get to see the fruit of your labors. I wish we could just beam you all down, Scotty, and take you down there and help you to see what you're doing. It's great. And thank you so much.
Well, thank you, Danny and Susan. I apologize, Susan. I didn't know you were going to be sharing. I would have introduced you as well. So But it's a blessing to hear from both of you. It's a blessing to hear a bit of what the Lord is doing at El Rancho. What I want us to do now is just to take a moment to pray for the ministry of El Rancho. So would you please join with me in lifting up prayers to our Father, petitioning them for the good things that he's already doing and the good things that he wants to do. Heavenly Father, we are so grateful to you for the opportunities that you give us to reflect your love to a world that needs it, a world that is in desperate need of knowing there is a Father in heaven who loves them. And so thank you, whether we're in Philadelphia or whether we're outside Monterrey, Mexico, you give us opportunities to reflect the love of a perfect Heavenly Father, which is what you are to us. Father, we just want to continue to pray for the ministry of El Rancho Del Rey. We thank you for the vision that you put in Ann's heart as a young girl and then put in Hank's heart as they married. And thank you, Lord God, for 65 years plus later, still fulfilling that vision and still bringing that hope to folks who are in so desperate need of it. Father, we thank you. We just want to thank you for the incredibly good work that you are doing right now, for the amazing provisions that you have already made, for the astounding things that you are doing in the lives of so many. But Father, we also want to petition you, and we also want to believe for even greater things to come. Father, we pray that you would give form to this desire to be able to minister to the young girls as well. Lord, obviously all of the practical challenges and the financial challenges and the logistical challenges, God, we just lay all of those at your feet. And we believe that you are going to provide your creative and probably unexpected solutions to the things that you are stirring in the hearts of Danny and Susan and others. God, we pray for the boys who are there right now. And we thank you so much for each one of them. And we pray, Lord God, that each one of them would daily have a deeper encounter with the risen Christ. That each day, Lord Jesus, you would be revealing yourself to them in even deeper and more real ways. Lord, we thank you for the many, many, many Rancho boys who have been transformed by the grace of Christ and who come back and report of the amazingly good work that you have done in them. And Lord, we are believing you for many, many more. Father, we pray for ourselves. We pray that you would continue to place on our hearts a desire to partner with the work that you are doing at El Rancho. Father, make clear to us as a community here in Philadelphia all the ways that you would have us walk this out, to be praying regularly for the ministry, to be giving financially to the ministry, to be going as you open the door and lead us to do that. But thank you for the incredible blessing that El Rancho has been to us to be in this partnership with them. And so, Father, we thank you. We thank you that you are a good God. We thank you that you reflected in so many different ways. And we continue to trust you for the amazing work at El Rancho Del Rey. And Jesus, it is in your name. You are the King. And it is in your name, King Jesus, that we pray these things. Amen.